Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today we have a question sent in by Susan. Susan has a problem with a report created by Crystal Reports. If you have a question for the Netcast, please feel free to drop us a voicemail or an email, bill@MrExcel.com, and we can get to you on a future podcast. Now, here's Susan's problem. Susan says that when she creates a report from Crystal, Crystal is basically taking three rows to report every single record. So she has data in columns A, B, C, D, and E of row one, and then two annoying fields in just columns A and C of row two, and then a blank field in row three. And she said, is there any way that I can get this into a nice sortable data set with all of the fields on one line, getting rid of those blank rows? Now, here's what I'm going to do is I'm going to create two new headings. So I'm going to copy the headings over to columns F and G, and I'm going to create a formula in the first record to solve just the first one. So I'm going to set up a simple formula here that says equal A3, and a simple formula here that says equals C3. Now I want to create those formulas basically just so that way I have a pattern to copy, but I don't want to copy it to all of the rows. I only want to copy it to the rows that are basically the first row. So I have to take a look at this data set and say, okay, well, it looks like if column B is blank, it's not row one. Row one is the only item that has something in column B. So I'm going to select my entire data set. I'm going to hit end home to go to the end of the data, and then hold down the shift key while I hit the home key. That will select all of my data, and now I'm going to go to data, filter, auto filter. Now the auto filter is looking for a nice contiguous block of data because of those blank rows. That's why we had to select the whole data set. I'm going to go to column B and say that I want the non-blanks. Column B filter to just the non-blanks. Now that's very cool because it gives us just the first row of each data set. Now I can copy this data. So I'm going to use Control C to copy, select the other cells, and I want the visible cells only, Alt semicolon, hold down the Alt key and hit the semicolon, and now I can paste, Control V to paste. Now let's take a quick look at that data set. Now, if we go back and clear the filter so that way we can see all of the items, you'll see that indeed we've copied the second row from each record up to the first row. We now want to copy columns F and G, Control C, and we'll use Edit, Paste Special Values. And we basically now have a situation where the first row of every item from Crystal has all of our data. We can go through and delete rows 2 and 3. I'm going to do that by sorting by column B. Again, I want to make sure that I select the entire data set before I sort. So I'll select that data. We'll use data sort and say that we want to sort by the second heading. Click OK. And that basically gets all of the rows that have something in column B to the top. I can now go through and delete the other rows. So, while it's very annoying that Crystal Reports is giving us the data in that weird format, using a few extra steps and using some relatively advanced Excel tricks, we can get it down to a nice sortable data set with all of the fields on one row. You wonder why Crystal didn't do that in the first place. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.